Hey guys, it's Dagan from PMTV UK, wishing you the merriest of Christmases from myself and the rest of the folk here at Professional Music Technology. It's been a bloody good year for gear, hasn't it? A very good year, and I hope you enjoyed myself and the rest of the PMTV UK crew demoing it and talking you through how to use all the lovely little bits of kit. The video that you guys seem to be digging the most is the 7 best small tube amps for home use, which at the minute, just before Christmas 2017, is up to 425,000 views. And I cannot thank you enough for those views. Hopefully it's helped someone get a lovely nice tube amp for the house. Off the back of that though, I've noticed there's some very, very colourful comments about me in that video and the rest of the videos, to be fair. So in the Christmas spirit of making people laugh, I thought myself and the lovely Alex Wardle, who films everything I do,
hello,
would go through a few of those comments and
I brought you a whiskey.
Oh, you brought me a whiskey?
Yeah,
it's a Christmas.
True Christmas spirit.
Why, have you got a whiskey? You're driving me.
No, I've got a hot cocoa.
You got a hot cocoa?
Yeah, driving you home later on.
So yes, off the back of that, we thought we'd go through some of our most colourful, funny comments and make us laugh and make you laugh. Let's go. So because we've just mentioned that 7 best tube amps you can use in the house, we thought we'd start with comments from that video.
Yeah, and I mean, we did get some really nice comments as well. Obviously, like you said, that video has been really popular. We've had some really nice feedback. Thank you to all those kind people.
Yeah.
But then we've got stuff like from the Electric Hobo. Oh my God, he's a pound shop Phil X. Which I can kind of see.
I can kind of see. I do get this. I get a lot of people saying I act a bit like Phil X, and like this guy is just trying to be Phil X, and they've obviously made him watch a Phil X video before he dances around and stuff. No, that's just genuinely the person I am, but I do love Phil X. I've been a fan of Phil X for years. I saw the drills twice to the UK, and he's a very, very nice man, Mr. Phil Zendis, I think is
that. So take it as a compliment, basically.
I mean, it as a compliment. I will be a pound shop Phil X.
Yeah, the pound shop thing's maybe a bit hard.
As long as I'll be a 25 pence Phil X. As long as me and Phil X are in the same sentence, the lovely, handsome man.
Fantastic. So same video, down a shot every time he says no and love.
Right.
Which, and this is particularly good because 140 people have actually thumbs up his comment.
Yeah, right. The thing with this no and love thing, Fender sound we all know and love. Sweet Fender sound we all know and love. To get that Marshall tone we all know and love. I used that as an awful crutch in that video. I didn't even realize I was doing it, and watching it back, I was like, oh man, I say the sound that we all know and love. We all know and love about 400 times in that video.
I mean, you can literally just,
wish I didn't,
scrub through to any point in the video and you're never sort of more than 20 seconds away from
a
we all know and love.
We all know and love. And it's awful. And the rest of the video is from them. Like, if I'm repeating myself more than one time, I'm like, well, do you cut this bit out because I'm saying it? And all the guys on the comments are going to comment on the fact that I keep saying Fender too much.
So you've made him quite sensitive to it now, guys.
I know, right here, it gets me.
Right, I'll tell you what, Dagan, because we've got quite a few of these mean comments to go through, why don't we talk about our favourite gear from this year?
Yeah, like have a bit of a positive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's bring things back to, you know, happy.
Yeah, positive. Yeah, well, I'll push them tears back in and unfurl my fists.
But don't worry, we'll come back to the mean comments in a little bit.
Yeah, so we've done quite a few videos this year. We're trying to do one every Thursday. There's a couple of videos, which is quite nice, whether it be a long list or individual things from said list. What would you say are your favourite ones of the year?
I think my favourite was probably the 7 cheap guitars that don't suck.
So yeah, that was great. We've done that one recently.
Yes, it's obviously very, you know, like applicable for this time of year, for Christmas and stuff, people buying guitars for like the kids and the loved ones and stuff, or, you know, maybe just want something, already got a guitar, but they want something a little bit different, but not really sure what to get, don't want to spend loads of money. I found it really kind of, you know, interesting being on this side of the camera as well.
And it was loads of fun to play.
Yeah.
Those cheap guitars are great fun, as you can tell by my facial expressions. It's a lot of fun. Some of the cheap guitars are great, like the Slash-On was great, the Epiphone SG was great, and those tiny Ibanez are awesome.
Yeah, that Slash Epiphone sounded like amazing.
Yeah. I really enjoyed the Orange pedals we did, the fur coat and the getaway driver. We have Zach up from Orange when we do those Orange products, and Zach's a lovely guy, and he tells me what to say with those things, and those pedals are just fantastic. And Orange is the brand where you can, like I say in that video, you can hit a chord and you can hear every note of that chord, whether it be a compression pedal or an overdrive pedal. It's such a thick sound that they have, but the clarity is unbelievable. Respect for Orange after this year, some of the stuff they brought out. Next year is going to be good as well because it's their anniversary.
This one's quite an extensive one, so I think I'm going to let you read this one yourself, Dagan.
Bubbles Bandino, 159 upvotes. So there I was, thinking to myself, there's something missing from YouTube gear guide videos. What is sorely needed is a new voice, combining the coke-addled spasmodic annoyance of Phil-X with the flamboyant, irritating, stilted banter of Russell Brand, but with some original traits like A, questionable sense in 1980s hard rock jewelry, B, a sensible wristwatch, and C, an Ernie Ball red strap. Yeah, yeah, that's what we need. Oh, bubbles!
I mean, wow.
Oh, it's just before Christmas.
I mean, 10 out of 10 for everything, like accuracy, effort.
Yeah, the Russell Brand thing as well. I get thinking of Russell Brand quite a lot just because I move my hands. I gesticulate a lot when I speak. I've got a beard and long hair and I'm British.
I mean, we could make a separate video just for all the Russell Brand comments that we've got.
Oh, hell yeah. I didn't know Russell Brand played guitar. A lot of Russell Brand comments. And this jewellery is expensive, man. I work hard in the PMT coal mines to afford this jewellery and I'm getting slated on it. Some guy says, where's Dagan from? He looks like he's from Yugoslavia. Very nice video, by the way.
I mean, do people from Yugoslavia have like a...
Do you ever feel when you're watching a video, I need to point out where I think this guy comes from?
Yeah, exactly. Like, it's the 21st century, people. Come on, it doesn't matter where
he's from. So what if I'm from Yugoslavia? I'm not, I'm from Newcastle. Like, born and bred, I've just got a little bit of a tan and... this facial hair.
Maybe
and all
some
that
Italian market. Heritage or something. Yeah.
Yeah, down the line, somewhere.
But someone else on another video actually commented saying they thought you were Australian because of your accent, which really surprised me because I don't think they're alike, really.
I don't know where the comment is and I can't bother to scroll through, but there's a huge thread somewhere of people trying to ask where I'm from. I think he's from the northeast of England. No, he's definitely from Cumbria,
like,
or Yorkshire.
Like starting their own little conversation.
Yeah, they're having a conversation, like four guys, are where I'm from. I'm from Newcastle, born and bred, it's mint. Not from Cumbria, I'm not Australian, I'm not Italian, I'm not Irish.
There you go. The mystery is solved.
Back to the Russell Brand and Phil-X thing, I was stumbled across. If Phil-X and Russell Brand had a baby.
All caps.
All caps.
Caps warrior.
All caps. No exclamation marks, just all caps. Then 301 people have liked that. underneath that though, that was Brendan Fraser. This is Snooze 00. 7 cheap guitars that don't suck and are available to purchase in your shop. Pointless and pathetic.
What? I mean, what would be pointless and pathetic is if we didn't have them.
If we did 7 guitars that you couldn't buy that were good for the money. Here's 7 guitars that I made in my garage from my neighbour's fence and they're for sale. You can't buy them.
No. Another one of my favourites was the effects pedals for keyboards video that I did with Gaz. Because
of Scottish Wonder.
Indeed, who unfortunately couldn't be with us today to share our whiskey and fireside chat. I think he's off in the Upside Down with Nancy Wheeler or something.
He's definitely, he'll be very happy to be in the Upside Down with Nancy Wheeler. He has such a soft spot for that girl. So if you're watching, Nancy, give more guys a call. He'll be happy to have a chat with you.
Stranger Things, available on Netflix.
Stranger Things, Netflix. Endorse us.
Yeah, no, I thought that video was cool because it was obviously something a little bit different. We're kind of combining, you don't really... You know, I hear about effects pedals being used with keyboards as much as you do with guitars.
No, obviously. Definitely.
So we kind of, you know, we went upstairs to the tech room in PMC Newcastle, but we took with us a bag of goodies from the guitar cabinet downstairs and, you know, tried to see what kind of cool sounds we could get by combining them with some keyboards. And I thought that was really...
Yeah, it kept my interest as well. Like, I have no idea how anything techie works. If it flashes, it just scares me if it's got keys and stuff on. But I knew how all the pedals worked. So when Gaz put that video up, I was like, oh, this is actually pretty interesting. So if you're a guitarist watching this little video, give it a watch. It's pretty interesting how these pedals react with different instruments. It's pretty awesome.
Jim Blaine just straight up says, were all the good players busy?
Oh, Jim! Oh, Jim, I'm trying my best here.
Cuts right to
I know I'm not a Steve Vai or Gary Moore or John Mayer, but I'm trying my damnness, Jim. I'm trying really hard.
Damn it, Jim.
Damn it,
hurting
Jim.
His feelings. Well, the Josh 9150 might cheer you up a
bit.
He says, this guy's name is Dagan. Bet he's a Targaryen too. I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah, I'm a big Game of Thrones guy, so I reckon I think I'd be Targaryen. I do enjoy things like guitars, so I might be a little bit Lannister, but my sister isn't as hot as Cersei, so
I don't think I'd do it.
You've probably got some Dothraki in there somewhere, like the long hair and the beard.
I would be Khal Drogo if Khal Drogo was played by an 11-year-old girl.
I don't think preset 14 X Rhodes has anything to do with the late great Randy Rhodes. How about Crossroads?
This is on the Headrush video.
It is on the Headrush video.
Yeah, I go on for like 5 minutes about how the preset 14 Crossroads,
like
which
X
is an X Rhodes. I'm like, Randy Rhodes setting, yeah, then play Bark at the Moon or something. And thinking in my head, this doesn't sound very distorted. This isn't very Randy Rhodesy.
not much gain on this.
Some guy shot me straight down going, Crossroads? It's for Crossroads?
Yeah.
Ah!
Writing was on the wall with
right,
that one, but
yeah.
We didn't see that one.
It was a long day that day.
Never mind, eh? Stroke the fairy wall.
Stroke the fairy wall? What's in that whiskey? Quite fitting for that, actually, because that's obviously an Aldous Snow reference from Get Him to the Greek, where Russell Brand plays essentially me and travels across America to play a gig at the Greek Theatre, which is one day I might do that, but not drinking that whiskey. That's strong whiskey, man.
It's nice whiskey, though, isn't it? Don't have too much.
I love doing them washburn guitars. The washburn, yes. The ones that PMT had the mad sale on, I think my sale might be on. The quality of them guitars are absolutely astronomical for the price. That's like 300 quid for a guitar, that's like 800 quid. The neck access just blows me away, as you can tell in the little videos. I'm like, how the hell have we managed to do this? To get Seymour Duncan pickups, to get everything. They're just fantastic guitars, loads of different models as well. Get the look like Nuno Betancourt for 300 quid.
They certainly don't look like 300 quid guitars.
They don't feel like or sound like 300
quid
guitars.
3 grand
guitars,
to be fair.
Yeah, they sell themselves, like, because I work in store as well, as opposed to YouTube. And you mention it to these kids and they play it and they end up walking out with it and you haven't got to sell anything to them because they just play it and they're like, wow, this for 300 quid? Sound, I'll take it. Yeah, look at it. It's remarkable. The funnest thing I find, though, is the neck heel. Look at that. You can access everything. You can access Skynet as well as the 24th fret. It's mad. And this is how this bad lad sounds.
I wish the amps did more talking than you.
Ah, you need to know how things work and you need to know what things do. Granted, some people don't know everything you know, mate. So I'm telling people how to use this amp or this guitar and you just sit back in your chair or sit on the toilet or look up from your phone when you're driving and hopefully you don't drive into the central reservation and let me explain what this amp does to people, okay? Michael.
Feeling really strongly about that.
Yeah,
like really
I'm talking and I'm not that good of a player, so I need to talk to try and get through it.
And yeah, that other guy, James Garcia, is this guy a clone of Russell Brand or what?
Yeah.
Straight up. And above that one, damn, I didn't know Russell Brand played guitar. I guess people like this really have to exist. Turns in shame.
Does it actually say turn in shame?
It says turns in shame with asterisks, you know, like the little...
I guess people like this have to exist. Right, okay. I'm just gonna pretend that I didn't hear that one. I'm going out for Christmas with the family after
Jonathan
this.
Jonathan Freeze. Really harsh.
Oh, Jonathan.
Sebastian Malmsteen. I really hate that guy. He just sucks. I hate he's way too play.
Oh, he said there's a grammatical error.
Grammatical error.
Ah, I win.
Null and void.
Null and void, Mr. Malmsteen, if that is your real name.
I never knew Russell Brand played guitar.
No.
The raw sexual energy pouring off this guy. Douche.
Does it say douche as well?
It says douche. It's kind of all going... You know, quite well.
I mean, what's a guy called? Is it a guy?
Dr. Darko.
All right.
Could be either.
Could be, let's not be...
His picture is some kind of Pokemon thing.
So it might be a girl calling me a douche, but she's saying the sexual energy is just pouring off me. I'll take it.
Yeah, yeah. Take the positives from that one.
I'll take the positives from that.
And here I was thinking Russell Brand was completely talentless. K-T-G-E.
Oh, I mean...
I think it's a compliment, yeah.
It's a compliment, but I'm a huge Russell Brand fan as well, surprisingly.
Yeah,
I love it. I saw him play Newcastle City Hall a couple of days ago, and he looked at... Because he goes into the crowd when he does these things and talks to people and rips people to bits.
I was going to say, was it kind of like some weird glitch in the Matrix?
It was really good, because he looked...
Being copied and pasted.
He looked at me in the eyes and just went... And moved on to make fun of the next guy. So he was like, you've had it hard enough, mate, looking a bit like me. So I'm just going to gloss over you, but the mutual nod of respect, like when there's two guys at a bar.
He could have made that, like, the thing for that gig. He could have, like, absolutely toyed.
He could have told me a new asshole.
Mm-hmm.
That
absolutely,
man.
But...
He didn't.
There we go.
Thanks, Russ.
I'll tell you what other effects pedal I liked that we covered. The EHX Canyon.
Yes! That's an awesome little thing.
Yeah. At... for such a small little pedal, seem to have quite a lot of cool little features packed in there.
I'm just thinking, I'm looking at the blanket now because I bought one of them and I don't know where I put it. I think it's on a pedal board somewhere.
One of your many pedal boards.
Yeah, that isn't the Helix. So it's hidden away somewhere. But no, as soon as I did that video, I had to get that because it does every possible delay sound you like, and the looper in it is fantastic. And like I said, the little perk is that the LEDs, the sun coming over the canyon, so it tickles my pickle.
Reverse delay does what it says on the tin. It plays back exactly what you've just played, but backwards. Have a listen. What I like to do as well is turn my dry signal all the way off and just... It's amazing. The kids are going to have loads of fun with that, aren't they?
He should focus on playing correctly instead of doing weird moves and faces.
I'm trying to just play guitar and enjoy. It's the same as like when you go in a guitar shop, you just forget how to play guitar and you just play an A for a while. That kind of goes over when you work in a guitar shop. Like, we don't really care what you play because we hear guitar from as soon as we get to work till as soon as we leave. So you could be great or you could be crap and it'll just go over our heads. Mm-hmm. But as soon as you turn that red light on, to me, I'm like, oh man, this A chord's been playing a while. Maybe we need to do something else.
Like, yeah, learn some sweep picking and some, yeah.
The only time you can really get fully involved is when you have a little dance around, like you're on stage and stuff, and you do move around and I evidently pull stupid faces.
I mean, that's it, you know? If you're playing in a band, you're practicing with some people and, you know, you're kind of really getting into it and, like, you know, feeling the groove and stuff, and then the rest of them are just kind of...
Yeah.
You know, it's like, well, that's not good. That's not why you play music.
And I wouldn't want to watch a YouTube guy just standing there, shredding away, just... Yeah. Formlessly looking at the camera.
I mean, there are plenty of videos of people sitting on a bar stool playing guitar, and like, if that's what you want to watch, then that's fine as well. Yeah. But you know, it's got a bit of pizzazz.
While the noose is getting like warm for you, you just sit and watch these guys in the
You're going to be joining in these main comments soon, aren't you?
I like it. It's coming through. It's that little sip of whiskey I had. It's going straight through my fingertips.
Oh dear, dangerous. Well, to follow up with that, Shane Miller. Yeah, dude hasn't bathed or slept in his meth binge.
Oh!
Please put down the pipe and turn that off, I think that says.
Oh, I don't look that methy, do I?
that's really quite harsh.
Again, going back to Mr. Bubbles before, like, try and look nice, wear nice bracelets and jewelry and stuff. Actually, the bracelets is a good one. There's a video I do where my bracelets are quite jangly. So apologies for that. People do complain that my bracelets are very jangly. But I have a fun story that Yngwie Malmsteen once sacked a sound guy again at Newcastle City Hall. And I know sacked his bait... No, story's wrong. He was sound checking and his bracelets were jingling into the bass player's microphone. And the sound guy was like, can you take your bracelets off, Yngwie? And he was like, no, the bass player just won't sing tonight.
Wow.
How crazy is that?
Brilliant.
So it's good enough for Yngwie. It's good enough for Dagan and PMTV UK.
There we go.
Bold statement.
Heard it here. Shane Miller again. This guy's on like a real mission. Jesus, could you imagine this dude living in your house? Yes, I couldn't imagine.
I'm in your house now, it's quite nice.
Yeah, I have a good time.
Yeah, my girlfriend seems to like tolerate me okay. That's okay. I think I kicked out of the house when I was 2.5 yet. That's a lie. I'm feeling people saying sorry for me now so they don't give me any more crap.
I don't think that'll happen.
Try look in the mirror, if you may. See if you can tolerate that, staring back at you, wide-eyed.
Yes, it's true. This guy is a legend in his own mind and room, and a certified
Oh, back to looking in the mirror, looking there. Yeah, man, you can do this video, Dagan. You're a bit of a legend, aren't you? Yeah, bring yourself up. Hey guys, it's Dagan from PMTV UK.
Bullshit video.
Just bullshit video.
Bullshit video.
All right, well, let's just knock over that guy. Let's not talk about him. Probably my favorite video of the year, though. I just thought there. I'm gonna give you a story here, YouTube. Like I said with Zach from Orange, we have some reps coming up. When we do certain videos, like when we did the boss videos, like the reverb and delays and all that malarkey. And for some reason, he just held that Boss Katana Mini back. You know, the little portable battery-powered amp?
Yes.
We had that back and he was like, we'll do this last. I'm like, it's just a small amp, we'll do it whenever I want to do it because I'm a diva. Not really. He's like, you'll be amazed. Like, it's just a small amp, like those little Marshalls, like little VHs. And he held up to the last, I was like, this guy's really hamming this up. Can't be that good. And I played it and I was absolutely blown away. It's by far my favorite piece of gear I've reviewed this entire year. I've got one in the bedroom. I was like, should I say I've got one in the bedroom? But no, I've got one in the bedroom.
Pride of place.
It's a great thing, even to play music through. You put your auxiliary in, and it's a 4-inch speaker, and I don't know how they've managed to do it. Witchcraft, I presume.
It must be. I mean, like you say, it is such a tiny little unit, and I thought the same thing, you know, when he kind of brought it in, and I was like, it's just going to be one of them kind of little practice amps. It's not going to have great tone, it's not going to be loud, and then was just absolutely blown away as soon as you plugged it in. I mean, that brown sound setting on it is obviously the kind of the go-to, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And I think in the demo you were kind of like, let's hear it clean. Yeah, there's a bit clean. Now let's go back to the brown sound.
And now it's possibly my favorite thing ever, which is the brown sound. The gain is like 1 o'clock, if you were looking at it as if it were a clock.
Clean crunch, which get about 5 seconds airtime each, and straight back to brown sound. It's got 3-band EQ, it's got built-in delay, which is just, you feel like you're sound checking in a stadium when you're in your bedroom. It's great.
Yeah.
It's fantastic, fantastic bit of kit.
Excellent bit of kit.
What I believe to be my product of the year.
If that means
anything to anyone.
Well, according to some of the comments we've read, probably not a lot.
No.
But to other people, I'm sure it will. It's got Dagan's seal of approval. So that Dagan, I believe, was 2017.
And what a crazy year it's been, man. It's been absolutely crazy, start to finish, starting with the NAMM show in Anaheim, California, seeing all the new stuff behind glass, to talking about it more in depth later on in the year with sat in a lovely hot or very cold PMT Newcastle some nights. But obviously, our way back to NAMM at the start of next year as well to talk about all the new stuff. Hopefully meet some more of my idols like Nuno Bettencourt and John Mayer, get some interviews, make you a little bit more jealous like John Mayer this year.
Yeah,
he smelled so good. Oh, seriously guys, John Mayer smelled amazing.
Good to know.
Such a nice smelling guy. But yeah, if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool, more guitar, music-related content from all over the globe.
And if you want any more info on any of the gear we've talked about tonight, any of our favourite gear of 2017, or any gear at all, go to pmtonline.co.uk.
Or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. Each one of our stores has its own Twitter, Instagram and Facebook page. Be sure to like your local one or them all.
If you're feeling that nice.
Yes, I've got a stupid catchphrase that Alex says.
I've been Alex.
And I've been Dagan.
Merry Christmas.
I thought we were going to like say something in unison there. We'll see you next time. Goodbye. Woo! Yes, I don't like this version, sorry.
You f*** off.
You go
no,
now.
No.
Good to go?
Yeah.
Wishing you the merriest of Christmases from myself and the rest of this folk. I'll do it one more time.
Yes.
You okay?
Go away!
It's been a bloody good gear for year. Well, it's been a good year for gear, hasn't it? A bloody good year. I need to stop saying bloody.
There we go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's been a bloody good gear. They're going mad.
Go, no!
It's been a bloody good gear for. Oh, f***ing, why can't I say that? That was class. Began absolutely rad.
Either one. Daft like. Go and see Dagan. Go on. I'm gonna kill yous.
And I can't.
No, out. No. Oh, come on, guys. Work with me here.
The videos you got just before Christmas 2017 is. Man.
Right, you're going
sorry.
Out.
Sorry.
It's not your fault. You're f***ing going crazy. Come on. Excellent. That was really good.
That was awesome, man.